Vancouver 1-5 in overtime. The Leafs are 7-2, including 3-1 in shootouts. Leafs to the left and change ends. Marner along with Marleau and Riley. Here's Morgan Riley working down the right wing, trying to drive the net. He does. He's right in a goal. Stop the rebound. And Markstrom was able to make the save as well off Marleau. Here's Granlund. Unable to get across the line. Marner took it away momentarily from Louis Erickson. Delzato up ahead. Gets the return pass. Had a man in front of the net. Now he does, but it's deflected wide. Erickson on the fireboards. They'll send it back and start a change. Leafs are going to get a change going as well. Back in on the right side for Besser. He hit the goal post.
No, they're calling it a goal.
Besser said that it was in.
No, I think it goes off both posts. I think it hits both posts and out.
Well, we're going to get a look at this before anything else. The Canucks are off the bench celebrating.
The referee is saying, looks like he's saying, hey, settle down, settle down.
Everybody hold on to their
coffee. I thought this went crossbar post.
Yes, it did. Yes, it did.
Brock Besser with a great shot. Off the crossbar, off the post, and out. The referee's there. Now what hurts is the Leafs had control of the puck going back the other way. It was signaled a goal. All the Canucks jumped off the bench. But this did not cross the goal line.
The video review judges are on their feet. They have accurately seen it. And now realize that Brock Besser has not ended the game.
Well, the officials have the headphones on, so they can't hear it.
Well, both
it's rare. I mean, we saw that in the game against Tampa where they stopped play.
Yep.
The buzzer went. But here it was the official 45 seconds into overtime has decided on his own. And I mean, it's hard not to believe this happened so quick. I don't care what vantage point you had. Here's the official call.
There was no goal in the play. The puck hit the crossbar. Faceoff going to be a neutral zone.
Goal line review brought to you by Vistaprint, official sponsor of the Toronto Maple Leafs. Help your business stand out with Vistaprint.
One of the oldest rules in hockey. Puck has to go in the net to count. Greg Gilbert knew that.
Did he?
Well,
you're sure?
I'm sure.
He was a forward, you know.
Oh, I know.
All right. Well, here we go.
Former captain of the Marlies.
Yes. Here's Gardner with Nylander and Matthews. Nylander skates to center, weaves in on the left wing, puts the brakes on, left it for Austin Matthews. Matthews back to Nylander. Nylander into the corner. Matthews with it again. Drops for Gardner. Gardner centers, and it's going to go off a stick and come to the line, but not out. Nylander keeps it in. Nylander doesn't shoot it. Near side, Gardner. Gardner works back out into neutral ice.
Slashing penalty.
Penalty coming.
This is a slash into the hands of Gardner.
There's Matthews in, and the shot is knocked away by Markstrom. And a slashing call will come to the Vancouver Canucks.
Well, maybe a couple of questionable tripping calls put Vancouver up 5-on-3 in the third period. And help them go up 2-0, but the Leafs get a break with a crossbar, goalpost, and now a slash. As, I mean, a lot of these are ignored, especially when it comes to overtime, but Jake Gardner sifting to the point. I mean, this was a hack into the hands of Jake Gardner, and Brock Besser is going to the penalty box.
And that will be ironic. If he's in there when the game is over, after he thought he had won the game. So it is 4-on-3. Bozak, Marleau, Marner, Riley. Back to the blue line, it comes to Morgan Riley. Riley to the near side to Patrick Marleau. Back to Morgan Riley. Looks for Marner. Marner holds. Tried to make a little saucer pass in there. Didn't work. He's able to outfight his man, but he gave the puck away. And Edler sends it down the ice. Riley. For Marner. Back to Morgan Riley. Riley into the left wing half board, drops for Marner, works back towards the blue line to Patrick Marleau. Marleau to Marner, Marner to Riley. Riley holds, looks for Marner, went off a skate, and it's come to the line and out. Marleau with five game-winning goals. Round the boards for Marner. Marner trying to chop it back in. The Canucks have been excellent in the penalty kill. Here's Jake Gardner, 1:04 to go. On comes Nylander. Nylander back to the point to Gardner. Gardner to Marleau. Marleau doesn't shoot it, still has it in the near circle. Passes across, blocked again by the Canucks, but not cleared this time. Gardner holds. Everybody's hollering for a shot to Marleau. Pass in front of the net, knocked away by Markstrom.
Very little movement on this power play for the Leafs.
Here's Gardner again to Willie Nylander. Cross ice pass, intercepted and shot down the ice. That took a bounce on Anderson. Quickly cleared for Nylander. Cross the line with Van Riemsdyk. Closing in with a shot. That's black. Where is it? It's gone up into the screen.
But this is easy to defend because all four Leaf players in the power play, nobody's moving. So if you're the Canucks, you might be down a man, but there's nobody sneaking up on you. There's nobody curling behind you. And I think that makes it very easier, at least a lot easier, for the defending team to get your stick in the lane because you got a sense of where everybody is on the ice. Would you agree? I just found that it was a matter, and then the Leafs are trying to force the pass through
a lot of traffic.
Yeah, two sticks to get it to a guy that's stationary.
Nylander got the draw free, but it is stolen, and now here's a 2-on-1 break going the other way. In across the line is Gabranson, and sprawling to knock that away was Morgan Riley. Canucks still in the Toronto zone with it, though. Knocked down on the play was Dowd. 2 seconds left in the penalty. And now, 4-on-4 until we get a whistle. Across the line for Matthews. Dropped it back, just kept in by Nylander. Nylander works back to the blue line. Still with it. And now comes out into neutral ice. He'll change. Means he taking it back.
Brock Besser out of the box. He's staying on for Vancouver.
Why wouldn't he? Here's Hainsey to center. Works to the line and in on the left wing. Sends a long shoot in on Markstrom. That's stopped. A minute to go in the overtime. A long lead pass went astray, and Anderson stopped that and gives it off. Hainsey up ahead for Gardner, rink wide for Bozak. His goal tied the game, and it goes into the crowd, so at least for 45.4 seconds, we're going to go back to 3-on-3.
And disappointing effort, I think, for the Leafs in the power play here in overtime. Great opportunity to win it. They lost on a power play goal in Colorado. The last game that they played that was decided in overtime. Of course, it was a shootout win against San Jose on Thursday night. But on the positive, 45.4 seconds to go. Nylander and Austin Matthews out with Morgan Riley. And still a chance to get things done here in overtime.
Dowd is out there. Well, they didn't do the faceoff cleanly. Erickson is the other player. The Sedins, because of the penalty and everything else, have not been on in the overtime.
No.
Nylander will face off with Dick Dowd. The draw scrum, but the Canucks control. Delzato takes it around back of the net. Delzato. No, he's not going to take off. He waits for Dowd to swing in the corner, and Dowd takes the pass. Dowd to center. 28 seconds to go. Dowd across the line, works to the near half boards and pulls back to the point. Delzato takes the pass on the far side, back to Dowd. Dowd trying to get around Morgan Riley. Dowd still with it, flips it off on the far side to Louis Erickson. Erickson just does keep it in, played it into the corner. Dowd taken to the boards by Riley, but can't fish the puck free. Erickson to Delzato. Wrist shot coming, knocked away by Anderson as the horn goes to end overtime.